BX Project is a no-profit foundation about visual art and photography. If you want to help us, just drop a donation on buymeacoffee.com/berlinexplorer. So, welcome to this 15 minute of experience. I'm with Daniel Pinto today, and welcome, Daniel.
Hi. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I am very excited for this interview. I am very excited for this experience.
So me too. So today we talk about you as a photographer, you as an artist, you as a human, and your experience. So before to doing that, I would love you to introduce yourself and can say where you come from, how old are you, what do you do in your life, you know, general stuff.
Oh yeah, perfect. Okay, I am Daniel Pinto. I am a conceptual and experimental artist from Quito, Ecuador. And my concept is based on the visual arts, focused or conceptual, experimental, and poetic photographs in constant transformation. And I make other works, like 3D works, 3D arts, in my other account on Instagram. And yeah, my inspiration comes from various emotions that have materialized through poetic verses or human experience as a model of catharsis and divergent emotional states. This has allowed me to see beyond my creative process and experiment with shapes, textures, space, lights, and a lot of colors. Thus, I have discovered my synergy between black and white and my sense of my expression of diverse, different situations in my life. I like exposing perceptions, portraits, amalgams, mixtures, and environments that with the passage of the time have helped me evolve along with my essence and my perspective in the environment in which I find myself. A cathartic experience that every day had allowed me to get to know myself better. Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, it's really interesting, your work, and it's really particular and fine. I can say it's really fine art, and I like a lot. I like a lot the way you express yourself. It's really tangible and gentle in the same way, and really keep to the details of what you show. And well, I like a lot also the way that is in a way or another blurred and show a kind of retro style that in a way touch in a different way our feeling. And I wanted to know how much you are influenced from the picture of the past. And it's something related to your family, to your country. Tell me more about that.
Yeah, okay. In my work that inspired in a lot of verses, a lot of fragments of my favorite poetic artist is Octavio Paz. Octavio Paz is an artist that you have, no, that, sorry for this.
It's okay.
Sorry for this. Octavio Paz is my favorite person that he inspires me in the concept or other concepts that I have exposed in my feed, in my work, in my imagination. And yeah, in my series I see a lot of situations of quotidian situations of my life or my own personal problems that that all this make me expose a lot of things that that cause me a problem or I try expose the liberty of the human, or synergy, or amalgams, or a lot of situations that the person don't say. And yeah, all this is very important for me, that in the words or in the details exists a lot of words, a lot of environments or cosmos. Yeah, amazing inspiration for me.
Yeah. I see. And I know that you're doing also 3D, 4D creation, and it's really impressive what you do it. I mean, I would love to have these knowledges to doing that stuff.
Oh, thank you so much for all the.
And in a way, I also see the possibilities that you can create images in 3D. It's almost we can say in a way you use your knowledge as a photographer also in 3D, then because you can catch the sculpture you make from different point of view, and in a way or another also this is a skill in photography, we can say, even if it's just a rendering or it's just a screenshot. In a way or another, it's a perspective that combines this technique in our tool in photography. And I really like some of the work you posted on Instagram. They are so detailed. And I like the way you use the texture and the disposition and the ideas also are really impressive, really.
And thank you.
And how do you usually compose that images? They are, where you get the inspiration to doing that? It's something you can relate to some of your dream, or I don't know, something you compose in other way. Tell me more about that.
Yeah, have a problem that this part speaking Spanish, or have a problem with this? We can this part in Spanish, or
if you want, you can explain in Spanish, and I hope that who listen this will understand. I mean, I can understand in Spanish, but yeah, will be why not? Tell me in Spanish.
Oh, thank you so much. But yeah, it's very important for me to say this in Spanish. Yeah, okay. Mi trabajo y mis conceptos principalmente se basan en diversos cuestionamientos que he tenido en mi mente, y principalmente es por ello que genero estos conceptos minimalistas, o simplemente que se enfocan en las situaciones emocionales que la gente de alguna manera escapa de ellas. Entonces, es un proceso para poder reconocer estos estados anímicos y que la gente también sepa que es un entorno primordial dentro de nosotros, porque nos expone cómo realmente somos. Entonces, es por ello que para mí es importante mostrar todo esto a través de composiciones sencillas, pero que se denote la fluidez en el movimiento corporal de los seres humanos, en el performance in the humans, también en texturas, jugar con texturas, con colores, con formas, pero principalmente con este lado oscuro y que contrasta con colores cálidos o fríos. Entonces, es por ello que he diversificado todo esto en un solo concepto, y me manejo principalmente por generar composiciones abstractas, pero que de alguna manera para mí exponen muchas cosas que siento, y así la gente, sea o no, pueda sentirse identificada con el trabajo que desarrollo, o como no, porque todos tenemos situaciones distintas que pasan en nuestro camino. Entonces, siento que de alguna manera puede influir en que se sientan libres de reconocerse como realmente son.
So I just make a translation now of what you said, no?
Oh, thank you so much.
what you said is that you usually want to recognize the details of all of your work.
That is
totally deep inside of the motion that usually we don't discover and we cannot in a way catch up. And then in a way or another, you feel yourself able or you should do it that to catch this kind of emotion there most of the time closed, yeah, and to give to them powerful to of communication, right?
See, mm-hmm. Sí, yeah, perfect. This concept is my important identification for my words, for my concepts, for my universe that have in my mind. it's very incredible that my work helped me in a lot of things in my life, in different situations that I have. All humans have a problem, but all humans have a way that help you, that help them in a lot of situations in your lives. For me, the art or the 3D art or photograph help me in a lot of ways in my life, and I feel that all this expose one part of my interperson or of my espacio personal interno.
Of space of internal personal internal.
Exactly.
Personal internal space.
Yeah.
yeah. I was mixing up the grammatic of the word. Yeah. And in your work as a photographer, otherwise, you're doing something else. Also, you don't work only with texture and object, but also with the human. When you relate to human, what you want in a way catch from these people? You can ask for me also in Spanish, and then I translate. It's okay.
Yeah, don't worry. In mis fotografías, principalmente trato de trabajar con el blanco y negro, black and white, that I feel is very expressionist, ¿ya? Todas estas fotografías que realizo las hago a blanco y negro porque siento que son mucho más expresivas con el lado interno de los seres humanos. Entonces trato de jugar con los retratos, más que todo ocultos o oscuros, para develar situaciones caóticas de nuestra cabeza o nuestro espacio interior. Y así es como he generado algunos retratos que próximamente estaré mostrando otros que he ido desarrollando a través del tiempo. Por este momento he ido trabajando en una serie de flores para mostrar precisamente el concepto de cada detalle de una flor y cómo puede generar esto diversas expresiones y diversas experimentaciones dentro de un solo fruto. Entonces siento que de alguna manera esto genera un ser y pasa a otro ser nuevo, que puede ser un color, una textura, una forma, pero eso es lo que le da el lado como mágico a cada parte de algún objeto o algún ser que habita en nuestro entorno, en nuestro concepto, o sencillamente tal vez no puede habitar en nuestro concepto, pero que de alguna manera se lo puede exponer. Entonces siento que es importante mostrar los pequeños detalles, porque siento que estos pequeños detalles nos cuentan muchas más cosas que lo que cotidianamente vivimos.
Okay, wait a second.
Perfect.
So I lost the following. So what you say is it's really important for you to get in touch with the darkness of ourselves.
Yeah, perfect.
And the work you do it is an internal process, come from your way to work in this obscure black and white feeling. And in this moment, you are working on a work inspired from flowers and the process to get in touch with the little details we generally don't get in touch in our life because they are too they require too time to think about them or to be seen from us.
Yeah, perfect. Well, I try in my work expose a lot of things that the humans have in your head. We cero miedos, cero temor, sino ser tú mismo, ser como nosotros somos y como nos podemos expresar de una manera más sincera hacia quienes nos pueden ver. Entonces, all this very important for me, and I try create a lot of photographs that help them or that help a people that exist in this context or in this world that sí, que puede ayudar a personas que vean el trabajo, como incluso puede simplemente ayudarles a desatar un poco su cabeza y poder ver algo tal vez distinto, que posiblemente para algunas personas es como muy abstracto. Entonces siento que lo abstracto a la final o lo sencillo es lo que tiene mucho más por darnos a exponer o por decir. Ok, yeah.
me gusta mucho tu trabajo. Eso es natural, es muy interesante. Creo que tú deberías continuar. But well, yeah, now I speak. I'm mixing my languages.
No, yeah,
yeah, and
Spanish is perfect.
Yeah, I really like the work you do it, and I think you have to continue. And that especially this exploring ourself and yourself in the details of also the object or the nature offer us every day that usually we don't. Really keep in touch with, and this is really interesting what you said. I hope that the people listen this podcast will also understand. I mean, it's easy to understand if they in the same time listening the podcast take a look at your picture, then they can usually get in touch, really easy get in touch with the words you said, even if they don't know the language. And it's really, really, really interesting what you said. And I hope to have another talk in the future with you and see the progress you're doing in your work, because I think, there are a lot of different door you have to open and also a lot of different door that you can find probably your way to express that in all over the world. I'm really looking forward to see your work more exposed in general, and I thank you a lot for your time and for your words, and it was really nice to meet you. And if I advise everyone to watch your picture and to discover your world, and to also with a bit of patience to translate what you write in your guide on Instagram also. That's really interesting, and what you write also in your post, it's really interesting because you spent also your energy in writing about the project you do it. And thank you again.
Thank you.
Everyone will find the link in description, and if you want to send a vocal message, will be really nice. Really curious what you think about the work of Daniel. If you want to engage a conversation, just use the last link in description. And for today, it's all. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for all this. For me, it's very important that I can express for this opinion or for these expressions that I have in my mind. Thank you so much for all this. And yeah, love this.
Thanks for listening to our podcast. Learn more about our project at allmylinks.com/Berlin Explorer. Or visit our Instagram and follow Berlin Explorer Project.